I was in a little bit of trouble for this week's video. I just wasn't sure what to do. So I called a friend to see if he could help.
What's up? You good?
Hey, Nick. How's it going?
Things are good. I have a little bit of a challenge, though. You know, I do the videos on YouTube, and and I sort of ran out of ideas, and I have like a deadline in a couple of days. So the idea I got, which is going to give you some extra work, sorry, was that, I do a lot of videos about building apps and so on, but I've never had a video where I actually build an app.
Today, we're going to build an app all in 24 hours for real and with no code.
This is Raw Startup.
I'm the founder of Vivino, the world's largest wine app and wine community with over 60 million users all over the world. It took us years to build a great app, but it's incredible what you can build now in just hours with no code. This should be a lot of fun. Finally, in this video, we'll look at what we learned from this small project.
What could we build in like 24 hours? Could we build something funny in 24 hours and then make a video about it? What do you think?
So we start with brainstorming.
We need to brainstorm here. We definitely should do something with AI. AI these days is just growing very, very hard. And in just 5 years, I think everything will be AI. And at the same time, we need to do something simple so that other people could repeat it, something interesting, something engaging, something that ideally involves photos or something, maybe like pictures, generating something. What do you think?
Yeah, for sure, because it's got to be something visual. It's an app, but it's something you can see.
This is getting interesting.
Actually, a friend came to me and he said he's playing around with ChatGPT and he had it generating stories for his kids. It sort of worked somewhat, but what if you had an app that could do that? Would that be fun?
Yeah, I definitely think we can generate, let's say, a text for the story using ChatGPT. We also even can generate pictures. For example, I think we can probably use Midjourney. Midjourney is just an, do you know Midjourney? It's an amazing app.
I've seen this picture. It looks wild, right?
Yeah, Jesus. I don't even know how they do that. That's crazy. No. We can use Midjourney, and for the app itself, we probably can use Flutterflow. It's an app based on Flutter, but it's just a little bit more easy and generates like, you know, all these blocks like Lego, and you can combine them. And we can do it like pretty easily, maybe like within just 1 day or something, 24 hours.
Okay. That's sort of what I need. Otherwise, I don't have the time to make the video, right? So how much input would we put in? Like how much data would we put into the app?
I believe not more than just one very short sentence. Even like OpenAI, you can generate like a huge story within just 5 words. So we can just ask the person to provide the prompt, like, what is the story about? And then they just, you know, we just generate a huge piece of text plus some pictures, you know, to kind of like give it more, to a little bit more visual.
I mean, that is pretty cool. 24 hours, really?
Yeah. Maybe even 20. I am 100% sure we can get this done.
Fantastic.
Let's try.
Let's do it.
Okay, Nik is ambitious. I like it. Let's go build something.
The plan is the following. Firstly, I need to prepare the functionality, then build, then test, and then show to Hany.
All right, let's start with the product description. Hany asked me that as a user, I want to be able to provide a short prompt so that I would be able to generate a story that contains pictures and text. This is overall goal of this app. The functionality that I think we need to do is the mobile app, which I think we'll build in a tool called Flutterflow, the text generation, which I think we'll use ChatGPT. We need to generate pictures, and for that, I think we'll use Midjourney, and we need to connect all of that, and I think for that, we'll use Zapier. Important to know that everything we need to build without writing a single line of code, only using no-code tools, only with that way we'll be able to build it like really, really fast. So that's why I think we'll use Flutterflow, Zapier, ChatGPT, and Midjourney, and this is our stack. Okay, let's go. Okay, so this is a very simple, but at the same time useful diagram of our app. We'll build the app itself first, then we need to use Zapier integration, which will be connected to ChatGPT to generate text, and to Midjourney to basically generate images. And let's try this out. Okay, so I have a pretty bad news. It will be very hard to build this kind of an app in Flutterflow. For Flutterflow, it's just too complex to build apps within 24 hours. It's pretty easy to do it in 1 week probably, but definitely not in 24. Okay, everything becomes more and more complicated. I stand up with Midjourney, and seems Midjourney generates pictures very well, but unfortunately, according to their API, they do not allow to connect it to anywhere else. Midjourney doesn't provide an API access to the bot through third-party apps or scripts. This is very sad.
So I'm going to talk to Haney and try to convince them to use something else, because unfortunately, neither Flutterflow nor Midjourney doesn't work in this case. I think that we'll probably have to use Adalo and some other tool.
Hey, Haney, how's it going?
Things are good. I'm excited about this project, man. I want to see the storytelling app.
I'm honestly not that excited. I tried and I spent maybe at least 10 hours nonstop today, and I realized that unfortunately, Flutterflow probably will not work as well as Midjourney itself. And this is very sad.
Okay, but Flutterflow, there's a lot of different ones, right? You can just use something else, right?
Yeah. So I tried Flutterflow. It is very great, and we can eventually get this done, but definitely not in 24 hours. It's just much more complex than expected. Yeah, just slower. And even if we'll show it to someone, people will not be able to repeat, unfortunately, I guess.
So Flutterflow is not going to work. What about alternatives? What do we got?
There are multiple. There are Builder, there are Adalo, and we can even do it in Bubble. But I think the number one we should try is Adalo. They're very easy, and I think we could definitely make something happen in a couple of hours. Let's try Adalo.
Okay.
What do you think?
Okay, so let's go for Adalo. So, look, I love having pictures in there. I think it would suck if we don't have any pictures in there.
We should definitely do pictures. There are a couple of alternatives. I know Stable Diffusion, or we can even use, let's say, like Dall-E. I would suggest Dall-E because as far as I know, they have direct integration of through Zapier. So we should try that. What do you think?
Okay, so you think we can do a picture still? Okay, that's good because
it would be a little bit boring. Yeah, I'm 93% sure. I'm 93% sure. We need to try that. We definitely need to try. I just need additional, I don't know, maybe like 7 hours or something. I will not sleep today, so just give me some time.
Have an espresso, man.
You too. Bye.
Thanks, man. See you.
Just talked to Haneem. Unfortunately, we have only a few hours left, and the apps that I tried just don't work. So I'm going to try Adalo. And probably Dall-E for generating pictures, and let's see how it will work out.
Okay, obviously some challenges, but we are moving forward.
I just rebuilt the app after my talk to Haney, and this is the new schema of the app. Instead of Flutterflow, we are going to use Adalo, and instead of Midjourney, we are going to use Dall-E, which has direct integration to Zapier, and that one has direct integration to Adalo. It should be easier. All right, I tried Adalo, and I think we definitely can make this work. I made three screens here. The first one where we actually asked the person to provide what the story will be about, then the loader, and then the screen with the story itself. And this is how Zapier integration works. Everything is without writing a single line of code, very simple, just basically like 8 steps. Number one is a trigger. So what should happen so that this integration will be triggered? And as a trigger, I used here a new record that was created in Adalo. What exactly is when there is a new kind of like story name, what the user provides. So let's say I want a story about Spider-Man. So Spider-Man will be that initial trigger. Then there is the action, which is conversation in ChatGPT, meaning that we just send this data to Spider-Man to ChatGPT, and back we receive a huge like piece of text, the story itself.
When you build with no code, Zapier is really the key. It sort of ties everything together. Really a fantastic tool. Nik sort of ties it all together in Zapier.
So now let's finally see what we have created. In order for this app to work, we need to provide a short or a long prompt or slash description or the title of the story, what the story will be about. Let's use something weird. For example, Superman and Spider-Man. Let's see what we generated. Because the app works with multiple tools such as ChatGPT and Dall-E, unfortunately, it takes some time to actually create the story. There's a lot of content. So that's why we're going to wait. I will wait, and I will just pause the video and we'll restart when it's time. The time has come. So I'm excited to see what the app generated for us. Hope it will not be weird. Okay. So here we go, Superman and Spider-Man. So the app provides the first picture, then a piece of text for the picture. Then based on this content, it generates a new one, and then like a new one. Where is Spider-Man? What is Superman? It's very weird though, but still. and this is kind of like the summary and the ending of the story. It's always weird, and sometimes it's fun, sometimes it's strange. But nevertheless, you can click on the button, create a new one, and provide a new prompt, and basically start all over again.
Okay, I just finished the app. And it's time to send it to Haney. I'm honestly a little bit scared and excited. So let's see what he says.
Now let's see what he's built.
Hey, Haney, how's it going?
Things are good. I mean, you sent me the link. That was incredible. I mean, how could you do that in 24 hours? This is obviously AI too, right? It's pretty wild.
Yeah, I loved it as well. I'm honestly a little bit surprised that we actually made it happen, but it's amazing. It literally, like, did you see how it generates everything? Four blocks of text and pictures and so on. It actually works. What story did you generate?
I did a story about a monster that lived in a rock in the Faroe Islands. So there are a lot of pictures of rocks and the Faroe Islands. It was really cool. I'm just impressed that you can do this. And I mean, you could also ask yourself, could you do this a year ago?
I'm quite sure that probably no, but I'm quite sure that in a couple of years from now, we literally will be able to do everything, even maybe like VR apps or something. So we'll see.
It is astounding to see what you can build with no code and AI. And yes, you are lucky. You can actually try the app yourself. Link in the description. Okay, before we get to what we learned, I would like some ideas from you. We'd like to do another bigger app project. So if you have ideas, put it in the comments. If you don't have ideas, look through the comments and put a like on it. And we might just build that. Now let's have a look at what we learned doing this project. If you want to move fast, use Adalo instead of Flutterflow. Flutterflow gets too complicated. ChatGPT is incredible. It can help you build a lot. Make sure whatever tool you're using has an API and that API connects with Zapier. You really don't have to code. This can be done with no code. And you can actually build something in 24 hours. It's pretty wild. If you want more content just like this, please consider pressing like and subscribe and you won't miss any future videos. Thank you very much for watching Raw Startup. Now stop watching, go build something.